You guys, what's good? Welcome to Jacked episode 19. So pull day today. Hope you guys enjoyed that last previous unorthodox gym session. It was a little funky. So a little update on my physique right now. I obviously finished my cut, and right now I'm sitting at 169, so 5 pounds heavier than my cut weight, the lowest weigh-in. And now my focus is to dial my nutrition back in because I've been eating out and stuff and eating untracked calories, things like that, which is fine. You don't have to be restricted all the time. Just going back on a structured diet, and my calories are around 2,800 now and 2,500 on non-training days. So 2,800 look like 350 carbs, 230 protein, and like 57 fat. That's on training days. And then my non-training is 250 carbs, about 70 something fat, and then 230 protein. The idea here is just to get my body adapted to a little bit higher calories without shocking it too much. Common mistake I've made in the past, and I don't know if you have either, but when you finish your cut, the brain automatically goes into this mode of like, oh, I'm gaining now, right? So I can eat whatever I want. And this is where we end up eating way higher than maintenance calories, and we put on a lot of extra fat because we stop doing cardio, we stop getting our steps in, and we just end up eating a lot more than our body is used to. So the body has all this new stimulus attacking it, and that ends up getting stored as fat. Was not used to it for like a significant amount of time. For me, like 7 months on and off here and there, but like most of the time deprived in terms of being in a deficit, lots of cardio. And then if I go directly quick opposite where I start eating a lot more, the body's gonna tend to put on some fat, right? And like, for example, like just in like a couple of weeks, I'm already up 5 pounds. I'm 169 right now, and I was 164 to 166 consistently during my end of my cut last few weeks. So now I'm hitting 169 pretty much every day, right? Which is already a little bit higher. And now I can tell, like, my lower belly, the fat's already starting to come in. So, yeah. Your body is going to put on fat really quick if you end up just eating way more. Okay, so you have to be a little bit more strict with yourself, even post-cut. Like that 1-2 months, sometimes longer. If you can stay dialed in, you're going to get more rewards from that cut you just did by maintaining a good amount of shape and physique, right? So that's the aim right now, and hopefully I'll take you guys along with me with that, right? If I don't keep eating out, even though I'm eating out tonight, but I'll be careful with it, okay? See you guys inside the gym. Body bit juicy, pull day. We're gonna hit some start with some pull downs, going to some rowing motion, arms training with another jack guy today, Mayher Joth. Fucking beard sicker than mine, so should be a fun one. I'm actually, you guys, so first exercise we're doing neutral grip pull downs, two main sets, one set 8 to 12, one set 12 to 15, so obviously go a little bit heavier and lighter. We already did our warm ups and our main set. This is the down set now. Main things here is think about elbow down towards like almost like your big toe instead of back here, okay? So you're just getting the lats going before the whole workout starts. You'll also see another jack guy in the video, so you'll see him push some nice weight, which will be fun. Okay. Oh, yeah. Fuck, bro. Keep flying. Nice. Easy. Nice, bro. Come on. Let's go. Come on.
Maybe like two more, eh?
Huh?
Looked like you had two more. Yeah.
Maybe you want to get re-acclimatized.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. Second exercise, wide grip pull downs. Upper back is a bit more focused right now. So we're starting with a wide grip pull down as like a more upper back focus. And then we'll do a couple rowing variations. Main thing here again, like we did neutral grip pull downs, two sets. One set, that'll be our top set, 8 to 12. Or 6 to 8 actually. And then we'll do a lighter set, 12 to 15. Main thing here is think about pulling the bar apart as you're coming down. Instead of jerking that shit, stabilize yourself, heels in the ground, pads into the thighs, lean back slightly. That'll be a more active range of motion, and just pull that ball apart, pause at the bottom, and enjoy the gains, okay? Alright. Actually, let's go a little bit heavier. Brampton ref. Brampton ref kicked him. You guys, so third exercise, single arm dumbbell row. Similar as the other ones. One top set, 6 to 8, and then one down set, 12 to 15. I'm actually going to go for 110s instead of 120 this week. Because my low back, I feel a little bit from yesterday's squats, which I shouldn't have done, but it was still fun. So 6 to 8, main thing is think about elbow to hip. And get that stretch at the bottom position, okay? Make sure you strap up. Not bad. It's pretty good. Do. Yeah, yeah. You want to actually go? And then I'll go. Okay. If you have a training partner, you can switch east side. Okay. Try this out.
That's what they say. Like, right? Recovery, right?
Yeah, yeah, yeah. It's especially like legs, right?
Yeah.
Bulgarians and stuff.
Yeah. Now also, there's another guy. You got trained by George.
Okay.
Sorry, you got trained by AJ.
Okay.
His name is George Osborne.
Okay.
That's where I got it from. And he's like, you're doing a single arm
movement. Arm or like, yeah.
Just give yourself 30 seconds in between.
That makes sense. That makes sense.
Otherwise,
you
probably get less on
that. Let's go, bro. You probably go heavier, no?
Yeah, I'll feel it up.
Okay. Alright. Easy. Come on. Let's go. It's easy, right? Yeah, probably got 130, 140. One set. Oh shit.
Was it Eagle? Brampton.
Yeah, Brampton. But yeah, rows I can tell. If I'm doing like 120, 25s, like I think 150, 160s are pretty. So fourth exercise, chest supported row. Three sets, 8 to 12. Main thing is we're more upper back, so the elbows are gonna be out here instead of close to our body. And main reason we're doing a little bit higher volume, just cause the other ones, bit more fatiguing because they don't have as much stability. This is a bit more stable, so we can send it, okay?
boy.
Easy. Come on. Let's go. Easy. You guys was good, so we're ending off with some pullovers and some face pulls for the back. Three sets, 12 to 15. We're going to fail. Yeah? There you go. Main thing here, keep arms straight, tricep locked out. Think about keeping your shoulders forward and then bringing it down towards your big toe. Full stretch, big toe. Full stretch, big toe. And then face pulls. There you go. Now you can rip it, bro. So, huh? All right. Think about pulling this apart. Pull it apart. All right. Woo. Easy. Nice, bro. Come on. Squeeze. Ooh, good shit. Come on. Let's go. Ending off with some preacher curls. We did high cable curls, but I don't have the mic on. This one, two sets, 8 to 12 with a drop set. Get that crazy peak, okay? So, set yourself up. Your elbows are on the pad. And then, full squeeze. Think about reaching forward, stretch. Ooh. Lord, play around with it. I might be a little light for you, but felt pretty good. Yeah. Let's go. Easy. Easy.
Hey guys, what's good? So that was a pull day. Hope you guys enjoyed. I know a little different pace of training. Actually, it's pretty similar. Got it done. Didn't record the posing part just because I was running a little bit behind. Every time I train with people, like even the other person, like we like talking, like catching up. Especially MJ, cool guy. Known him for a minute now. He's fucking jacked, right? He's getting back in the game consistently again. So we had some good talks. And it's always just good to talk, right? So I don't want to be like on the camera the whole time. So if you guys notice a little bit less continuity, that was probably the reason. But still, probably one of my best sessions in a while. I felt pretty jacked. The physique actually looked pretty good, even though I didn't record that part. And yeah, hope you guys enjoyed that pull day. One more thing, me and MJ were talking about this is when you tend to fall off certain things, right? Especially during the holiday season, people, you know, take time and that's needed. Four days of like not tracking stuff or like not being on point, it's not gonna kill the gains, right? So understanding that, but then also understanding if you make that a habit and you get too complacent, you can fall back in your old ways fairly fast, right? Because there's this joke in the fitness game, it's like this whole fitness thing is a little bit of a scam, because the harder it is to, not harder, the amount of effort sometimes it takes to, you know, get certain results, it almost takes the same amount to maintain it or keep progressing, right? So when you take your foot off the gas a little bit, you notice your physique start to go downwards a little bit, right? So, which is fine. It's part of the game. I think it makes it almost like the fitness game a little more fun, right? Because you have something to look forward to constantly. So it's a good thing. But knowing that can be a really important factor in the long-term game. You know what I'm saying? So, yeah, hope you guys enjoyed that pull day. If you're finding you are slightly falling off or finding it harder to get back into, change your environment, change the place you're maybe training at, change the people you're training with, maybe reach out to a coach, reach out to somebody to train with that you know, like you want to be like. If you surround yourself with people who are like doing a little better than you or the physique that you want, it's going to help you accelerate your progress and get back the momentum quicker, right? So yeah, change your environment and it literally can change everything. Okay, so hope that helps. Hope you guys enjoy that pull day and take it easy. Okay, bye-bye.